Good morning, good morning. Hey there, Heartbeat Queen. Oh, hey, Heartbeat Dalitha. Hey, Heartbeat Anita. Hey, Heartbeat Tanya. Good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Aaliyah. Heartbeat Andrea. Good morning, good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Troy. It is Friday. Hey, Heartbeat Christine. Good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Val. How are you? Good morning, good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Eva. That's right, Heartbeat Eva. Happy Friday. We made it to the end of the work week. We made it. Hey, Heartbeat Carolyn. Happy Floodgates of Blessings Friday. Oh, we love that. Happy Floodgates of Blessings Friday. Hey, Heartbeat Belinda, Heartbeat Smitty, Heartbeat Elaine, and Heartbeat Donald. Good morning to you guys. Happy Floodgates of Blessings Friday. We're going to take that. Well, guys, good morning. Good morning and welcome to the Gathering of Hearts. I am Regina Banks, your GPS to wholeness. Welcome on this morning. And your daily dosage is this. Relax, get some rest, part two. Hey, Heartbeat Juanita. Relax, get some rest, part two. So we know on yesterday we talked about getting some rest and casting our burdens over to God and leaving them there and coming to Him and allowing Him to get rest. And I know that that is easier said than done. You know, some of us are so busy. We're doing this, we're doing that. And it seems like rest just is not in the schedule. Like, if I rest, something is not going to get done. But we've got to learn how to rest in God and allow God to be who He is in our lives. We've got to make sure that we are not so busy that we miss the hand of God in our lives, that we miss the rest that He's trying to give us, and that we miss the blessings because we're super busy. And so we've got to learn how to slow down and relax and truly, truly, truly enjoy this life that God has given us. We know in Daniel 7 verse 25, it says that Satan comes to wear the saints out. And so we are, you know, we know how Satan is trying to take us out. He says that he came to steal, kill, and destroy, but Jesus came that we might have life and have life more abundantly. And so God wants us to be able to rest and enjoy this life. Life abundantly doesn't mean toiling, doesn't mean struggling. That's not what it means. But if we take the time to rest, we can then hear God, which means we can operate the way God would have us to operate. Amen. And so what I want you guys to do, like I said, is part two, because now I'm going to give you some steps in finding rest. Amen. It's one thing to talk about it, but then we got to have some steps and ways on how to make these changes, ways on how to renew our mind that we might enter in a state of wholeness where there's nothing missing, nothing lacking, nothing broken, and enjoy the life that God truly has already planned for us. Amen. And so steps to finding, we got to also realize before I go into the steps that resting it in God is important. It's when we rest that He can restore us. It's when we rest, brokenness turns to wholeness. And it's when we rest that we can hear Him. Amen. So let's look at some steps to finding rest. And they all are in the book of Psalms. Amen. So as I go over these five scriptures out of the book of Psalms, make sure when you have time at resting, that you go back and you read the entire Psalm. Amen. So the first one is seek God when you can't sleep. Seek God when you can't sleep. Psalm 4, verse 3, and I'm reading it out of the Message version. It says, look at this. Look who got picked by God. He listens the split second I call to Him. Then verse 8 says this, at day's end, I'm ready for sound sleep, for you, God, have put my life back together. And so when we learn, when we have moments when we can't sleep, that if we call on God, if we seek God, He will give us that sleep. The Good Word version says this, know that the Lord singles out godly people for Himself. The Lord hears me when I call to Him. Verse 8 then says, I fall asleep in peace the moment I lie down, because you alone, O Lord, enable me to live securely. And so when we are seeking rest and can't sleep, we need to always seek God. My grandmother used to tell me, when you can't sleep, that means God wants to talk to you. And she told me that like as a teenager one time, and I was like, I can't sleep, grandma. And she was like, that's because God wants to talk to you. And it kind of like stuck with me. So anytime when I can't sleep, I begin to call on God. I begin to talk to God. And then I listen. Most of the time when I'm listening, he tells me something and then he puts me right to sleep. So I know that that works. Number two, trust God wholeheartedly with your life, your present and your future. Psalm 16 verse 11, and I'm reading it in the Passion Translation. It says, because of you, I know the path of life as I taste the fullness of joy in your presence. At your right side, I experience divine pleasures forevermore. So as soon as I come into contact with him, I experience his pleasure. I experience his fullness. The Easy Reading Version says, you will teach me the right way to live. Just being with you will bring complete happiness. Being at your right side will make me happy forever. And so when I learn to trust God wholeheartedly with my life, where I am right now and the future, that gives me rest, because I know he's the author and finisher of my faith. And I know that all he has are good plans for me. Amen. Number three, allow God to cut in and take the lead. Here is where most of us have our problems. We want to lead our own lives, but we are not our own. We don't belong to ourselves. When we gave our lives to Christ, our lives then belong to him. And it is he that will transform us. It is his word that will renew us, where we'll be able to do these things that God has for us. Psalm 23, we all know this one. Verses 1-3, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. The New Living Translation says it like this. He lets me rest in green meadows. He leads me beside peaceful streams. Doesn't that sound like rest? Doesn't that sound like comfort? The Common English Bible says it like this. He leads me to restful waters. And so when I allow God to cut in, and I allow him to take the lead of my life, and I stop trying to lead my life, I'm able to get rest. Verse 3, he restores my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake, not my own, but for his. And so here's another way that I'm able to relax and get some rest. I allow God to take the lead, and I let him guide me. I let him lead me. I realize that I am his follower. And so when I begin to follow his plan, think about that. The plan is already there. It's already been orchestrated. All we have to do is follow. We don't have to come up with the next point B or point C. No, point A, B, C, all the way to Z is already there. And all we have to do is follow, allow him to lead us in this life. Remember that he is already prearranged and predestined for us. And so all we need to do is follow. Number four, stop toiling and receive the rest that God gives us in sleeping. Stop toiling and receive the rest that God gives us in sleeping. Psalm 127 verse 2, the NIV says, in vain you rise early and stay up late, toiling for food to eat, for he grants sleep to those he loves. The Message says it like this. It's useless to rise early and go to bed late and work your worried fingers to the bone. Don't you know he enjoys giving rest to those he loves? And so the Bible tells us that God gives his beloved sweet sleep. And so God wants you to rest. He wants you to be comfortable in knowing that he's your God, that he's your sustainer, that he's your provider, that he's your deliverer. And when we begin to allow God to give us this rest in sleeping, we will get rest. We will be able to relax. Number five says, quiet yourself in his presence. In other words, learn to be still. Learn to be still. Psalm 131 verse 2, the Passion Translation says it like this. I am humbled and quieted in your presence, like a contented child who rests on its mother's lap. I'm your resting child, And my soul is content in you. Content, satisfied, content, state of peacefulness or happiness. And so when I allow myself to be quiet, allow my soul, allow my spirit to quiet itself in God's presence, I'm able to get rest. Because when I'm in his presence, it's like, again, I'm like a little child sitting on mommy's lap, sitting on daddy's lap, just resting and taking in all the love, taking in all the peace. And so if we are ever going to get to a state where we can truly hear God all the time, we've got to renew our mind and start learning how to relax, how to have fun, how to get some rest. It is then, remember the account with Mary and Martha? Mary was sitting at Jesus' feet, but Martha was concerned about the busyness of the day. And what? She missed who God is, who he was, or at that point, she missed it. And then she got upset, was like, tell her to help me. And Jesus was like, girl, get out of here with that. Mary understands who I am. Mary understands that I'm in her presence. Mary understands that the best thing to do when Jesus is present is to sit at his feet and to worship. Amen. So don't let the busyness of every day cause you to miss Jesus, cause you to miss rest, and cause you to miss relaxation. You've got to learn how to relax and get some rest in Jesus. That is your daily dosage for today. I am Regina Banks, your GPS to wholeness. If you have not already subscribed to the YouTube channel, please, please, please do so. There you can get all of your dosages in one place. And I promise you, overdoses on these dosages, you will not have any negative side effects, none at all. In fact, it will make you the better. Amen. Follow me on social media platforms, God Wants Me Whole. Visit the website, GodWantsMeWhole.org. And come on, let's end it how we do it. Say, God wants me whole, and I am getting whole by the minute. Again, I am Regina Banks. I love you guys a bunch. Have a fantastic weekend. Make sure you relax. Make sure you get some rest so that you can hear the direction that God is trying to give you for your life. Remember, there's already a blueprint. All you have to do is follow. Have a great weekend, and I'll see you Monday morning.